Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with News Tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Home Minister Rajnath Singh allays fears on publication of the final draft of the National Register of Citizens of Assam, assures Rajya Sabha that everyone who is left out of the list will get a chance to appeal, condemns attempts to disturb peace and spread misinformation on social media to attract international attention. Bill to restore provisions in the Scheduled Caste and the Scheduled Tribes Act introduced in the Lok Sabha. Union Cabinet approved the new bill on Wednesday in the wake of the Supreme Court verdict that diluted some clauses of the Act. Modi government's signature scheme Ujjwala Yojana beats deadline 8 months before schedule. 5 crore free LPG connections handed over to the poorer sections. Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan congratulates Prime Minister and Petroleum Minister for the achievement. Scheme targeted to reach 8 crore beneficiaries by 2019. Rajya Sabha takes up bill to arrest decline in Parliament's productivity. Akali Dal MP Naresh Gujral introduces the private member bill. Members debate the Parliament Enhancement of Productivity Bill 2017. Seek a minimum 120 sitting days in a year, starting proceedings an hour early at 10 a.m. And Lok Sabha passes the National Sports University Bill in the Lok Sabha. The bill replaces ordinance, will facilitate a sports university in Manipur that will boost sports-related research and training, besides having an outreach to many other countries. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on Friday appealed to members to cooperate for the smooth conduct of the House. He asserted that approximately 30 bills are pending in the government's list of business for the remaining monsoon session of the Parliament. He added that it will be a sad commentary on the working of the House if it is unable to do justice to the legislative agenda. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu sought cooperation of all the members of the Rajya Sabha on Friday for smooth functioning of the House for the passage of crucial bills. Around 30 bills are pending in the upper house.
Please cooperate in proper conduction of the House. These are all around 24 major bills and some other related bills. And they are all equally important. It will be a sad commentary on the functioning of our House if you are not able to do justice. How many bills you want to take, that's finally, I am not going to say anything, it's for the government and the Parliament finally. But they are all important. So ministers' duty is to bring to the notice of the House what is the government's proposed agenda, how many you are going to pass. That is left to the House.
Earlier, Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs, Vijay Goyal, enumerated the bills slated to be taken up in the upper house.
Sir, I rise to announce the government business for the remaining part of the monsoon session. The business consists of consideration and passing of the National Trust for Welfare of Person with Autism, Cerebral Palsy, Mental Retardation and Multiple Disabilities Amendment Bill 2018. Consideration and passing of the following bills as passed by Lok Sabha: the National Council for Teacher Education Amendment Bill 2018, the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Amendment Bill 2018, the Homeopathy Central Council Amendment Bill 2018, the Criminal Law Amendment Bill 2018.
The current week saw repeated disruptions and adjournment of proceedings of the House over the NRC issue. The monsoon session of the Parliament commenced on 18th of July and will conclude on August 10th. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
And Home Affairs Minister Rajnath Singh on Friday reiterated that the recently released National Register of Citizens of Assam is only a draft and not the final version. Responding to the concerns of the members of the Rajya Sabha, Singh assured that no coercive action will be taken against anyone. Singh strongly denounced any attempts to vitiate communal harmony in the country by some for vested interest and said that the matter relates to national security.
Assuaging the concerns of members of the upper house on the Assam's draft National Register of Citizens issue, Home Minister Rajnath Singh stated that the whole procedure was fair and transparent and was supervised and monitored by the Supreme Court. People will have a chance to furnish documents to prove their citizenship of Assam, and those who are not included in the final NRC list will be able to appeal to the Foreigners Tribunal.
भारत सरकार तथा असम राज्य सरकार इसके लिए पूरी तरह से प्रतिबद्ध है कि टाइम बाउंड मैनर में सभी जेन्युइन इंडियन सिटीजंस के नाम एनआरसी में शामिल कर लिए जाएं और यह पूरी प्रक्रिया पूरी तरह से फेयर है और साथ ही साथ ऑब्जेक्टिव है कोई भेदभाव न हुआ है और मैं आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूं न आगे कोई भेदभाव होगा
Rajnath Singh also deprecated attempts to spread fear and smear the communal fabric of India. He underscored that NRC issue relates to national security and should not be politicized. Singh underlined that the NRC was based on the Assam Accord that was signed during late Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi's tenure.
Kuch vested interest wale vyaktiyon dwara social media par propaganda chalaya ja raha hai taki is mamle ko internationalize kiya ja sake tatha कम्युनल हार्मनी को बिल्कुल उसको प्रभावित किया जा सके यानी कम्युनल डिसहार्मनी पैदा करने की एक या कोशिश है मैं समझता हूं कि इस प्रकार का प्रयास किसी के द्वारा नहीं किया जाना चाहिए
Members across the party lines had expressed their views on Assam's NRC on Tuesday and stressed that it should not be looked at through the prism of religion or politics. Home Minister could not reply to the debate earlier due to repeated disruptions. The draft of the NRC was published on July 30th with 2.9 crore names out of the total 3.29 crore applicants in Assam. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
And after the Home Minister's response to the concerns over the NRC issue, members from different parties sought clarification from him. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu urged the Home Minister to furnish a written reply to the members.
आपने कहा कि बिल्कुल fair and objective process चल रहा है। अगर ये fair and objective process है, तो ये आर्मी 30 साल, एयर फोर्स 30 साल करने के बाद भी बाहर कैसे हैं? तो मेरे ख्याल में माननीय गृह मंत्री जी को कहना चाहिए कि प्रोसेस पे गड़बड़ हो सकता है अगर आप पहले ही कहेंगे प्रोसेस ठीक है तो फिर right. आगे करना क्या है
राइट right, प्लीज
ये मुझे आपसे जरूरी अनिवार्य कहना
thank you.
है
माय फर्स्ट सजेशन वी बीन गोइंग ऑन नाउ फॉर 47 मिनट्स वी हैव हर्ड द नेम ऑफ ओनली वन स्टेट असम दिस इज नॉट जस्ट एन असम इशू दिस इज एन इशू फॉर राजस्थान This is an issue for right. Punjab. This is an issue for UP. This is an issue for Bengal.
Right.
This is a national issue, a human rights issue, a humanitarian issue.
Right.
If possible, sir, thoda legal aid, hand holding, वैसे लोगों के लिए, जिनके परिवार के तीन सदस्य नागरिक हैं सर, दो सदस्य नागरिक नहीं हैं। नागरिकता को मैंने उस दिन भी कहा था, समुदाय और परिवार के दृष्टिकोण से हम नहीं देखेंगे सर तो ये पूरा का पूरा संवेदनहीन
आप 40 लाख से स्क्रूटनी दोबारा करने के बाद हो सकता है ये नंबर घट के 30 लाख पे रुक जाए या 25 लाख पे रुक जाए उनके बारे में भारत सरकार का क्या विचार है क्या प्लान है
thank you,
उनको क्या किया जाएगा उसके
thank, thank you,
whether the time limit will be extended that government will have to clarify Number two, whether the government will not allow any action because I think no action should be taken against those who
right.
do not find
right,
place
Rajya.
In the
Very
draft
basic points.
Whether the modalities will be changed or revised
right.
so that these people, those who are Indians from different parts of the country, especially from the south, can they give their, can they be proved that they are Indians, they are citizens?
Unique Identification Authority of India does not share its data with anyone except as per the provisions of Aadhaar Act 2016. Electronics and Information Technology Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad informed the Upper House that Aadhaar has built trust among people at large and some devious elements are trying to spread misinformation.
Do
Responding to queries during question hour, Electronics and Information Technology Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad clarified that Aadhaar contains robust security measures and protects privacy. He also asserted that the Aadhaar database wasn't hacked to compromise details of TRAI chairman.
Sir, as far as that particular case is concerned, the UIDAI gave a public statement that the claim was wrong. And also UIDAI publicly issued an advisory to all concerned, please you don't unnecessarily disclose. But sir, I will ask a question. My distinguished...
You can't ask
No, sir. In reply, sir. Anand Sharma is a distinguished national leader of his party and deputy leader. His mobile phone is available on the website of Rajya Sabha. His address is available. We are in public life. In a digital world, we leave footprint. But what is important? Core biometrics. This and iris should never be broken, has not been broken, and we consciously undertake the audit to ensure its
Thank
security.
Desh ka jo contract act
hai, Replying to another question, Minister of State for Agriculture, Gajendra Singh Shekhawat said, four states had started work on the new Contract Farming Act.
Mani Sabhapati Mahode, 22 Mai ko ye Contract Farming Act humne desh ke rajyon ke samaksh prastut kiya tha. Kyunki abhi is lagbhag 3 mahine ka kalkhand bita hai. विभिन्न राज्यों ने अपने स्तर पर इसकी प्रक्रिया प्रारंभ की है तमिलनाडु उत्तर प्रदेश उड़ीसा और कर्नाटका इन चार राज्यों ने इस दिशा में काम करना प्रारंभ किया है अभी किसी भी राज्य सरकार ने ऐसा बोर्ड संसूचित किया हो इसकी सूचना अभी इस 3 महीने में प्राप्त नहीं हुई है जो पूर्ववर्ती सरकार समय में जो एक्ट बना था उस एक्ट को 21 राज्यों ने अपने यहाँ पर लागू किया
Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution Minister Ram Vilas Paswan informed the House that in order to improve the liquidity position of the sugar mills to enable them to clear cane dues of farmers, the central government has extended assistance amounting to about 1,540 crore rupees.
Yes. कि हम क्या कहते हैं कि जो import duty है, वो import duty क्या कहते हैं कि maximum कर सकते हैं। तो import duty 50% था। अब 50% से बढ़ा करके हम लोगों ने 100% क्या कहते कर दिया है और जो एक्सपोर्ट ड्यूटी क्या कहते था वो एक्सपोर्ट ड्यूटी 20% था उसको रिलैक्सेशन करके 0% कर दिया है अब उसके बावजूद भी मान लेते हैं कोई हम कंट्री वाइज तो नहीं चलते हैं कि हम एक कानून क्या कहते कि एक कंट्री के लिए एक बनाएंगे पाकिस्तान के लिए दूसरा बनाएंगे तो जो हमने रिलैक्सेशन दिया है 100% दिया है और सरकार तो इम्पोर्ट नहीं कर रही है ये ओपन मार्केट है तो उस मामले में सरकार के द्वारा मार्केट में रिलीज हो कितना चीनी बफर स्टॉक बनाने का काम हो जिससे कि किसान को पैसा मिले और किसान को पैसा तभी मिलता है जबकि मिल मालिक घाटे में नहीं चलता है
right.
तो हम मिल मालिक को घाटे में रहने देना नहीं चाहते हैं और किसान को पेमेंट करवाना चाहते हैं और उसके बाद भी मिल मालिक पेमेंट नहीं करता है तो राज्य सरकार की जवाबदेही होती है उसके खिलाफ में कड़ी कार्रवाई करे
नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन 182
Questions were also raised on fake news on social media, illegal diversion of urea by fertilizer companies and recruitment of Group D posts in railways. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
And Rajya Sabha members on Friday expressed concern over the decline in the number of days of Parliament's functioning. Members requested extending the sitting to a minimum of 120 days a year, along with the working hours by starting the proceedings an hour early at 10 a.m. Expressing concern over the frequent adjournments, few members said that the loss of working hours should be compensated either by adding more hours or by working on additional days during a session. The members expressed their opinion during a debate on a private member's legislation brought by Shiromani Akali Dal member Naresh Gujral.
My bill is that if parliament session is or parliament proceedings are disrupted, then automatically the number of hours that are lost in disruption, that should get added to the session.
Have a system of special sessions. And I'm glad that the Honorable Member has made it part of the bill. We must have a 15-day session in a year in which no government business is transacted.
कि कम से कम 100 दिन राज्यसभा चलेगी लेकिन जिस तरह से पिछले वर्षों में देखा गया है यह अवधि निरंतर घटती चली जा रही इस पर सभी माननीय सदस्यों को चिंतित होना स्वाभाविक है
डिसरप्शन को हमें अवॉइड करना है डिसरप्शन ने डेमोक्रेसी की आत्मा को मैं समझता हूं कि काफी हद तक उसको लील लिया है
कि हम चेयर को अधिकार इंटरेस्ट करें जो वेस्टर्न पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी में वहां के चेयरमैन को है कि अगर हम एक अनुशासन से आगे जाते हैं तो उनको ये अधिकार है कि उस पर कार्रवाई कर सकें।
And Home Minister Rajnath Singh on Friday raised the matter in the Lok Sabha of TMC MP's arrest and accused them of creating an unruly situation at the Silchar airport. He said they were detained in view of intelligence inputs received by the Assam government on the law and order situation. He further said that since there were prohibitory orders in Assam, state officials had requested TMC MPs to return from the airport itself. However, the TMC has said the detention and manhandling of their party colleague at the Silchar airport shows there is an undeclared emergency in the country.
And law and order situation ko maintain rakhne ke liye ye situation deteriorate na karne paaye is baat ki chinta karte hue jo bhi wahan sammanit sadasya gaye the unko airport par डिटेन किया था और उन्हें वापस जाने का भी अनुरोध किया। डेलीगेशन के मेंबर्स ने उनकी बात न सुनते हुए वहां के सुरक्षा कर्मियों के साथ आर्गुमेंट और धक्का मुक्की की जिसमें दो महिला सुरक्षा कर्मी इंजर्ड भी हो गई थी।
And the Lok Sabha on Friday passed the National Sports University Bill 2018. The bill proposes to set up the first of its kind National Sports University in Manipur at par with the international standards. Leaders cutting across the party lines supported the bill.
The Lok Sabha passed a bill to introduce the international level sports university on Friday. The university will be located in Manipur and will offer several sports courses in its curriculum. At present, various schools and universities teach physical education. This university will be unique with many important departments, including sports-related research and training. The university will also have an outreach to many other countries. Sports and Youth Affairs Minister Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore said an MOU has also been signed with universities, including Canberra University.
अपने आप में स्पोर्ट्स का जो पूरा एनवायरनमेंट है उपाध्यक्ष जी पूरे 2019 तक 80 बिलियन डॉलर की ये इंडस्ट्री होगी पूरे विश्व के अंदर आर्थिक रूप से भी और व्यक्ति निर्माण से और एक्सीलेंस से हमें इस धारा में जुड़ना है और हर चीज जहां विकास होता है प्रगति होती है वहां कहीं ना कहीं शिक्षा जरूर जुड़ी होती है
मेंबर्स ऑफ ऑल पार्टीज वेलकम्ड द नेशनल स्पोर्ट्स यूनिवर्सिटी बिल इन द लोकसभा
सरकारों को शिक्षण संस्थानों को परिवार को समाज को अपनी सोच में बदलाव लाना होगा 12-14 साल के बच्चे को ये नहीं कहना कि केवल पढ़ाई की ओर ध्यान दो खेलों की ओर भी उतना ही ध्यान देना होगा
विद एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ दिस नेशनल स्पोर्ट्स यूनिवर्सिटी आई विश एंड होप दैट इन 10-12 ईयर्स टाइम टू कम वी विल बी एबल टू प्रोड्यूस एथलीट्स ऑफ मोर मेडल्स इन एशियन गेम्स कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स and Olympics.
Establishing sports infrastructure and encouraging the sports and games is very important for promotion of sports to meet that of international standards.
Debate on the bill started on Wednesday with RSP MP N.K. Premachandran questioning the government over the need for an ordinance. Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore said in January this year some courses were started in the university. And in an absence of an ordinance, students could have faced difficulty. The sports minister also emphasized that it will facilitate better coordination between the states and the federation. Navikram Singh's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And for more on this, we'll go across to Dr. P.S.M. Chandran, former consultant, Sports Authority of India. Sir, thank you so much for speaking to Rajya Sabha Television. Sir, my first question, what are the key objectives of the National Sports University Bill 2018?
As I understand, that is to promote sports in the whole sector, especially the new training as well as sports sciences, which is lacking in Indian sports. The university has been established with this objective, and it is commendable that it has gone to Imphal, which is in Manipur, which is which is an area where a lot of sportsmen are coming up day by day. Mm. So it will promote sports in the whole region, especially in the northeast. And also, one should understand that in the past, only the NS Patiala was dealing with producing quality coaches, whereas this university will take care of that also, along with sports sciences. This so happened that today, 3rd of August, was 31 years back when the Indira Gandhi Institute of Physical Education Sports Science was established. And the 34 years ago now on the run, lot of work has been done by that particular institute, but to complement them, this university will also help. So it is always to be taken as a positive step by the government to establish a university in the country, especially at the Northeast.
So which sport this university is likely to focus on?
It is, as I understand, it's not one sport. The multitude of sports they are going to focus on, along with emphasis on physical education and sports sciences. So it's a three-way, three-in-one. That is sports, physical education, and sports sciences.
And so what we are understanding is that this university will be at par with the international standards. So what else is so unique about this this university as compared to other sports colleges and institutes?
I would mention a rider here. If it has to be at par with the universities abroad, the faculty has to be of highest class. And for that, you may have to find talent from abroad also. So it is better that in the formative years, especially in the first 5 years, we should find the right persons to head the university, especially the sports sports science or oriented administrators. And you may find it difficult to get these people within the country. So there is no harm if you look beyond the borders of this country to get that faculty.
And how will it help in promoting the sporting culture in India?
Because education is a part and parcel of every developmental process, and sports, if it has to be developed, you have to have universities and institutes promoting sports. And we are lacking in a good number of universities and institutes. As I said earlier, National Institute of Sports is the only sports institute of worth mentioning this country. Along with the university, it can complement sports culture in the country.
And what will be the role of the central and state government in the university?
They both will have to come in and pool the resources. The infrastructure has been coming up in this, in Manipur for the university, and the manpower recruitment is going on. And there, especially the being in the Northeast, there will be some difficulties for people to reach there. That has to be taken care of. For sportsmen, find it difficult to reach Northeast, but with development in more roads and rail and facilities given for air travel for the sports persons and sports-related persons, that should solve the problem.
And how it will help people to take up sports as a career option? How beneficial this university will be?
Well, nowadays people are looking forward to sports. Now the people have changed their attitude towards sports. Sports is a lucrative business for many people. And there are a lot of professional sports that come into sports and professional sports. League has come in and employment opportunities in the league as well as in the sports administration. Plus, when sports science are developed, the young boys and girls interested in science will branch into sports sciences. That will be another employment opportunities. Along with physical education, when it gets teeth, that means more quality physical education, the more brilliant students will come into physical education. When more brilliant people come to physical education, the whole standard of sports will come up in this country.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chandran, for joining us and giving us all those details on that important development. So the National Sports University Bill 2018 has been passed by the Lok Sabha today. Moving on to some other developments, Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment Thawar Chand Gehlot tabled the bill to amend the SC-ST Prevention of Atrocities Act. That was cleared by the Union Cabinet on Wednesday. The bill seeks to overturn a Supreme Court order which had laid down certain safeguards in SC-ST law. The bill rules out any provision for an anticipatory bail for a person accused of atrocities against SC-STs. It also provides that no preliminary inquiry will be required for registering a criminal case, and an arrest under this law would not be subject to any approval.
इससे आने से एक तो दलित समाज के लोगों के लिए उनके अधिकारों की रक्षा के लिए एक उचित प्रावधान हो सकेगा. सरकार ने उन सभी का ऊपर प्रावधान करने का एक जो पहले से उनके मन में जो दृढ़ता है और दलित समुदाय के लिए जो उनके हर रक्षा के लिए हमेशा खड़े हैं और उनके उत्थान के लिए नई योजनाएं आई हैं.
And the central government has achieved its Ujjwala Yojana target way ahead of time. Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan handed over the 5 crore free LPG connections under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana at an event held in the Parliament House on Friday. Lok Sabha Speaker congratulated the Prime Minister and the Petroleum Minister for the achievement. The scheme to provide deposit-free LPG connections to 5 crore households below poverty line was launched on May 1, 2016. The scheme to provide clean cooking fuel to poor families aimed to meet its target by 31st March 2019.
केवल मंत्री नहीं, केवल प्रधानमंत्री नहीं, कहीं ना कहीं अधिकारियों के मन में भी ये भाव आया कि नहीं, अगर ये अच्छी बात है तो मुझे समाज के लिए इसको मुझे भी पूरा करना है, सब ने मिलकर के. तो बधाई है आपको कि आज ये 5 करोड़ पूरी हो गई.
प्रधानमंत्री जी ने जो कहा था उसको पूरा करके दिखाया. हमें यह सौभाग्य मिला आज देश की 5 करोड़ गरीब बहनों के घर में हम चूल्हा पहुँचाए. आज तकदीरन बहन की घर में आज हम 5 करोड़वां चूल्हा पहुंचाए. ऐसे ही एक मौके पे आदरणीय लोकसभा की अध्यक्षा उस कनेक्शन को दिया. हमारी सरकार की प्रतिबद्धता गरीबों के लिए, महिलाओं के लिए प्रतिबद्ध है.
And Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu interacted with a delegation of MLAs from Meghalaya Legislative Assembly in New Delhi today. During his address, he discussed the role and importance of Parliament functioning. He also expressed his concern about the current disgraceful style of protest inside and outside the Parliament. He further said, such events made him upset as they degrade dignity of the Parliament.
Elected government, na? Right or wrong, people have given mandate to that government. You have to tolerate it. And then you must have be tolerant to others' view also. And India is a country which is having 760 languages, hundreds of religions, sub-religions, castes, sub-castes. So we have to keep their aspirations in mind and try to live up to their expectations. If the government is going wrong, protest here, then protest there outside, but do peaceful protest of destroying public property is of no use. Are attacking communities. Recently, an unfortunate incident took place even in Shillong also, I think. We should try to come out of such things. Otherwise, India will be weakened. Our image outside will be affected.
And other news which we have been tracking through the day is the Supreme Court today asked the Attorney General to frame holistic guidelines for its perusal and approval on video recording and live streaming of court proceedings. The Apex Court also asked the parties who filed the PIL in the matter to provide their suggestions to Attorney General K.K. Venugopal. Venugopal sought 2 weeks' time from the court to frame the required guidelines. The centre had said that video recording and live streaming of judicial proceedings can be undertaken on a trial basis in constitutional matters being heard by the Chief Justice of India's court. The matter will now be heard on 17th of August. And the centre on Friday told the Supreme Court that it had withdrawn its notification proposing a social media hub. The move comes after claims that it could become a tool to monitor online activities of citizens and would undertake a complete review of its social media policy. A bench headed by Chief Justice Deepak Mishra considered the submission of Attorney General K.K. Venugopal appearing for the centre that the notification was being withdrawn and disposed of petitions challenging it. Venugopal also told the bench that the social media policy would be reviewed completely by the government. On July 13th, the Apex Court had asked the government whether its move to create such a hub was to tap people's WhatsApp messages and observed that it will be like creating a surveillance state. And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. For more news and updates, keep watching Rajya Sabha Television. Namaskar.